Hey, horse people. Want to do a quick one on this little website here. This is a pretty good little website, but like all things on the internet, there's good and bad. And you're not going to agree with somebody 100%. Whoever, I'm assuming it's a her, runs this little website. She's got some good information about dangers of bit. Let's see here. Part one through, I think, five or six. Oh, no, seven. Good little website. If you go to her different pages, she shows how it affects the airway and how it's not good and different ways the way horses kind of come out. She's got good little pictures on how the bit affects the bars. Talks about a rope halter. Talks about how this is pulling and pressure, which is commonly confused with a bit in a rope halter. When you pull on a bit here, you get pain here, and you're actually pulling the horse into pain, and you're creating pain on the other side because this bit pushes against this face over here and pulls. So you're giving conflicting information. On a rope halter, which is why I like a rope halter or hackamore, not a mechanical hackamore, when you pull, it gives pressure on one side, and the horse moves away from that pressure, and he turns his head. And then you'll have the idiot saying that a rope on the outside of a horse is somehow more painful than a metal bit on the inside of a horse. I mean, it's just crazy the crap that people want to put out there. But this little video or this page, she did a really nice job. And she explains a lot of things about the damage of bits and how, you know, people make excuses and do stupid things. She gets into the nerves and how, I mean, she's done a pretty good bit of research, and I've only glanced at it quickly. So somebody's going to come here, do you know that she said this? And look, this drooling here, people are going to say, oh, that's it. It gets the, this is absolutely ridiculous. This is pure out, flat out abuse. This band is restricting the horse. This metal bit traps the tongue. This tight band. This is just the cruelest thing in the world, and people will see it and think it's beautiful, and the horse is trained so, I mean, it's just disgusting. But she gets a good point here on when you bend the horse head, when a horse swallows, how it cuts the airway, and so she did a really nice job. So if you want to check out her thing, now I'm going to disagree here on her, and I tried to leave her a comment, and I couldn't. She's got how to tie a rope halter. And it's wrong. It's not how you tie a rope halter. So if you go to this thing, she starts out correct as it comes through here, and then she blows it on step two. Anytime you see a knot above this loop, you know the rope halter's tied wrong. The rope halter has to be tied. The knot has to be below this top loop. If you see a knot above this top loop, it's wrong. And that's the way she ties it. She goes on top of it. It's totally incorrect. It may look correct. She's got this part down on how it wraps, but it's on top of the loop, and it should be below the loop. As I have this picture on my website, it goes through, and the knot is below this loop. This is the correct way to tie a rope halter. So, although she has some other good information, there may be other incorrect information. Her philosophy is understanding a horse more, so I like that, and she does a pretty good job. Another thing I wanted to show people is if you find a nice web page that you want to read and you may not have access, you can save a web page as a PDF pretty easy and then read the PDF without having internet access. So if you're going on a plane or you're going somewhere where you're going to lose internet access, it's pretty easy to save. I mean, if you right-click, most people go save as. If you save as, it's going to try and save it as an HTML page. So you want to print. So when you hit print, if I click on print, it brings up another thing and it'll say save. And then I've got, if mine is standard for PDF, and then all I do is hit save and it'll bring it. And now I'll have this web page saved as a PDF and I can read it later and I can have a copy of it. So if you hit save, it'll bring up your box, whatever your standard it is, And then it says horse and human PDF, and I can rename it in this area right here, and then just save it. So saving a web page as a PDF is a good way to, if you find a good web page and want to read it later, save it as a PDF. And like I said, some of the things she's got on here is pretty good, but a couple things may not be. I know the rope halter is definitely not what I call correct, and she's teaching the wrong way. She does show how to tie a, where's her little quick connect? I thought she did a, how to tie a quick release knot here. Yeah, here we go. How to tie a quick release. So the fact that she's using this stupid hay string thing, to me, takes credibility away from her, because I think it's just the most ignorant thing in the world. People out there think if you tie your horse to a hay string and the horse pulls, the hay string will break. And that's good for the horse, and that way your horse won't panic. When you see somebody tying their horse to a hay string, that tells me they don't know what they're doing. They haven't taught their horse to tie, and they're actually teaching their horse to run away. Because if a horse learns that all I got to do is pull and break a hay string, you're teaching a horse that when I pull, I get release. So her quick release knot, I'm not too concerned about. And then her how to, of course, how to tie a rope halter is incorrect. And how to attach a lead rope, this is one way, and it is correct. It's pretty easy. She's got a nice picture there. 1, 2, 3, run that through, and then your rope halter is connected. That's if you have a loop already. If you don't have a loop, you can still do it. Just run the wire through. And again, I have all that on my website. But anyway, just wanted to share this little website. She's got some good info on bits and the problem with bits and Roker and all that other stuff. So figured I'd somebody, either she shared it or somebody shared it. And I figured I would pass it on. All right, we'll end that there.